Hello, everybody. This is your old friend RJ City, and today we will be watching all, yes, all of the Who's the Boss intros and outros that they played during the show's run from 1984 to 1992. So if you love watching Tony Danza evolve, if you enjoy watching the cocoon larvae into butterfly of Judith Light or Catherine Hellman, this is the video for you. Without any further ado, here are all the intros and outros to Who's the Boss. All right, 1984. This was really like, we have to make it clear that he's leaving the city, that they were in the city, they're going to, what is this, upstate New York or Connecticut maybe? Road that's hidden. He's taking that. He's literally going around the bend. Just the worst van in the world. And if he had that van in New York, he wasn't parking it anywhere. There's no way he had this van in the city. But yes, they go to Connecticut. That's right. This is Connecticut? And this show always, to me, took place in the fall because of this intro. So many leaves. This shot was like, oh my god, get a rake, Mona. It's just ridiculous. And this is before you knew the characters. You thought, this is just someone driving to Connecticut. Is this what this whole show is about? I have no idea. And one person riding a bike. You don't even see Tony. And this is the outro. They had to really hammer home what a great father he was. And they're playing in this really tight, that's not a place to put a basketball net. Let's be fair, this is a tight set and also makes no sense in the grand scheme of, this is just not where you put a basketball net. Over the front door, someone's gonna get very, very hurt. Alyssa Milano has a good shot. All right, next one. We've established this. See, we're going boom, boom, boom. He's already in Connecticut. You understand this. And this was from the pilot episode. And the athletic prowess of Tony Danza. What a great physical comedian doing these little magic tricks. Oh, hello. Oh my God, what an athlete. Just constantly sweating and working out and doing vacuum tricks. And she's not. Judith Light is not sweating at all here. Tony's always either sweating or showering. Catherine Hellman is like, what, 38 here? Isn't this the way the old days were? I love, producer is Budweiser. Isn't that clever? Take my name off this. I don't want to be associated. Oh, and this is where, the do they or don't they? This was like, you know, the nanny was like the reverse Who's the Boss. And this is when, who could forget when it snowed? That episode when it snowed. This is, I can't remember that guy's name. He's just a wonderful character actor. But this is Tony taking care of business. He's got that rough street style and will keep everyone from getting walked all over. And Mona is there to comfort and there to understand, but also there to make sex jokes, which is important. And see, this is, they started having a good time here already by the second season. NBC television, I don't remember that. Because it was always in syndication when I would see it. So you never saw the original production. So here's the third one. We're going to Connecticut. We all remember this? Good. Yes, this was the classic, the meeting. And you can't not include the pancake flip. Really. And the sweater trick. It's just great stuff. Is this a remake show before? Why would you cut this? Of course. And the boxing. Oh, Tony, take me now. Why would you ever cut any of that out? What's different about this one? I guess Alyssa's older and Danny is a little older. Yeah, okay. So there's more focus on the kids as they come into their own here. That's a great, you start with these adults, they get older, but the kids grow up and start to take over. Yeah, this is all new. Other than the kissing and the whoop. Do they, don't they, will they, won't they? Who knows? And then, of course, when they did, as we'll see later, the show's basically over. Look at this. They're really deep into their comfort zone here. They're hitting their stride of Tony being goofy, you know? Michelle or Bust? See, Bust is over her breast there. That's a classic Mona joke. So that was a lot of fodder. You definitely see the kids are older here. And they show much. Is she sleeping with her male maid? Ooh, the audio's clearer here. There's that shot around the bend. We've put that back in now. This is interesting. We took a brought things in from the initial intro more. This is very weird. Maybe they ran out. See, Tony is older here. He's cut his hair. Everyone looks a little older, except for Mona. And the kids are so much older. It's been like 8 years since they started filming. He just looks less, like, he's more sure of himself now. I remember that sliding into home scene. Who could forget Tony's baseball game? There's a more sex play going on here. They're more coquettish. They're more comfortable with each other. But the kids are so much older. And Catherine Hellman is just stunning. The foot scene is just good. It's just good for the foot fetishes. And it's good to us. More nudity happening. More Tony nudity. And the baseball team was a great way to play off there. And do they finally go on a date? This is them. More in the kitchen now. Yeah, there's a thing. Okay, see? She gets walked all over. This guy, this large fellow, I guess he had a little run on the show.
How many Huxtables fit in a Brooklyn brownstone?
Oh,
well,
no.
If Denise is away and Sandra and Elvin,
you know what? Never mind. Don't listen to this man.
Yet, and Theo's still in high school.
This is not a guy that you need to listen to. He's saying nothing important.
Show is
Let's just skip it. Okay, here we go. Here's another intro. We're going around the bend. We're pulling up to the house again. We're including the leaf shot again. Very interesting. Again, the streets in Connecticut. The town should really be doing some cleaning. Anyway, Tony's having a good time. He always made things fun. That's why they really had him around, because his cleaning was shit. Oh, the boxing episode. In a wrestling ring, which always bothers me. Always. You should know the difference. And he's out here, by the way. When he slid into home, I hope they called him out. I don't know why that's their hero shot. But then you see, Alyssa is so much older. Danny is so much older, even though they used this from a couple years ago. And, of course, Catherine. Look, they're getting on each other's nerves. But that only heightens the passion and the sexual tension in between each other. They love any shot of new Tony they're putting in an intro. That's for sure. Any shot of romance, but any pornographic shot of Tony Danza, they're putting in. This is the outro. And then, you know, Alyssa, they were really, that became the focus. It's a father-daughter kind of thing. Not so much the mother-son thing. This is just, what is he having, a fantasy? A nun fantasy? He was such a good singer. He was such a good And now they tease it by having him kiss other people, like that man there. I don't remember that episode. Here we go. Driving to Connecticut, around the bend, leaves. And then we pull up to the house. We meet Angela with the towel on her head. Here we go. I'm the new maid. Here we go. That great leg over the... They're having a good time on the phone. Anytime their heads get close together, it made people very... Ooh, this is brand new. He went to college, I think. Right?
Could have finished my degree.
Not the best baseball player, but she's proud of him. Angela's very proud of him. And, of course, her mother. Alyssa's name was Samantha. Now it's just done. Oh, my God. Danny's so much older. Dear Lord. He's all of a sudden 48. It must be so jarring to see them grow up like that. They're having a great time. That house had way more rooms than it looked like on the exterior shot. Who could forget when they played that baseball game? Nobody deals with the logistics of getting jerseys printed. He's a great cook. And Emeril Lagasse, always putting more spice. That was, and she was, he was definitely his mother's son there. Brand New Life is the name of the song. And then do the kids have friends? Things are happening like that. He just wants to have a beer and put his feet up, but he can't do that. There's tension there. Great stuff. One of just... Oh, is this an episode where they drink? Oh, a drunk episode. An underage drunk episode, and then they probably didn't have applause at the end. It was a serious moral message. Around the bend, leaf shot, let's go. Get a rake, Mona. And then we're pulling up to the house. Then the one guy riding his bike in October or November, a rogue bike rider. Okay, we got that shot there. We got the laughing on the phone. We got Mona doing the cheerleading. And he's still in college. He's finishing his degree in, business. And of course, he got out at the baseball game. Seen this already. Yeah, we've seen this already. Beautiful dresser, elegant dresser. take. Alyssa's the same age here. Danny's the same age here. Wearing the oversized shirt as kids often did in the early 90s. I love how she played classical music. That was always, like, sitcoms thought the most annoying people listened to classical music. The camping trip, the old spit handshake, sexual tension, saliva, ooh. And they're still, we haven't quite turned the corner here on their romance. But he's bonding more with Mona, as you can see. Samantha is obviously growing up, and they start dating, and boys, and the high school, who knows what happens. Oh my god, she's so much older. All of a sudden, she's 30 years old. It's terrifying. And Tony has friends. Tony is a guy who was lucky enough to just be named Tony in every TV show and movie he was ever in. So that's 1989. Now we're getting into the 90s. Here we go. We're going around the bend. We didn't even get the first shot over the bridge. I think they altered the song a little here. Ooh, that clarinet. Very prominent. Is that a clarinet? Yeah, I think so. Oh, wow. Now they're full on. They're husband and wife, as far as I'm concerned. They are just, they are doing it nightly. And Mona's certainly celebrating it. And he's still going to school. He's getting his, maybe, I don't know, second year, third year. Certainly couldn't be his master. But they still put this embarrassing baseball shot. They're fully in romantic mode. And she's feeling herself. And Mona's still there. Mona's supporting her. Samantha has a job. Danny is so much older. He's really coming to his own. Mona has not changed a lot. But Tony and Angela are just, this is it. And who can forget, Tony is a tap dancer, and he takes every opportunity in real life to wedge it into his show. Look, I can do a little stuff here. You guys want to see it? And you can see now it's husband and wife, and now I'm sure they realize we're rounding the corner here. We've come around the bend in many ways, and we're going to be wrapping up this show sooner than later. Nice bomber jacket on Danny there. Now we're getting into high school parties, fun stuff. Oh, the parents are coming home. Clean up that whole thing. And I don't know what they're talking about. Good. They always have a nice, emotional, cathartic, a hug. Somebody's hugging somebody at the end because an emotional understanding has been achieved. We've lost the bridge shot again. We're going around the bend, the leaf shot, and then we're pulling up to the house. There we go. And then here's the, we start with the shot again, as we always did, but now they're in love. See how far we've come. They're dancing together. They're playing tennis together. And Mona's still Mona. This is basically the same. So what's new? All of this has been the same as the last one so far. Tony's certainly very happy about it. And of course, the derogatory baseball shot, the fantasy dancing scene, more dancing from Tony. We always need it. This has all been the same. Her in the gym, this was also the same. Mona the same. What's gonna change here? Ah, that old wacky guy. Everyone's dancing. Okay, maybe this. Nope, we got the tap dance. He's tap dancing in sneakers. This is a new shot. They added just one new shot? Literally one new shot. I think the electric guitar took over, but you can see how much older they are here. And how many hijinks they're getting up to. Do they move into a new place? Maybe this really is the end. He's still kissing whoever he wants. He's a Casanova. This so much kissing. This season was just like everyone must kiss. These are the rules. I think Tony has it off with her at some point. Oh, Lord. They're just traveling and they're leaving. And that's the end, I guess. And then, I don't know. Somebody dies. There's an early death or something. Well, those were all the intros and all the outros to Who's the Boss. It was so great to see the children come so far and evolve into adults. And it was so nice to see that romance, that burgeoning will they, won't they, and they finally did. And then you feel the comfort, you feel the love, you feel the joy. They really belonged together. But whether they got together or not, the important thing is that there were enough gratuitous shots of Tony Danza sweating, showering, and tap dancing.